What's up, Internet?
Happy St. Patrick's Day! I care, Zach doesn't.
I didn't even know it was St. Patrick's Day.
Are you even Irish?
No.
Okay, then I don't care. See, my mom used to My mom used to be like, I'd wake up in the morning.
Oh, wow, that doesn't work at all.
Yay!
Okay, well, Joe, you're gonna have to fix that.
Well, thanks for the resub, Apple Knees.
That needs to be fixed.
I'm still happy. My mom used to make green milk on St. Patrick's Day, and I'd come down and everything would be green, and I'd be all pissy because I had to go to school. So now I like St. Patrick's Day because I don't have to go to school in the mornings.
Okay.
Yeah, I just wanted to share that.
Man, if we don't get that resubscribe thing, we're going to just get, like, slammed here. Yep. Yeah, you need to fix that right now.
Oh.
Or I might have to leave the room and fix it. And that'll derail this entire show more than you can derail it.
Oh, don't you dare challenge me. Guys, I think he challenged me to derail things.
No, I'm not. I believe me, I'm really not. Yep, and it continues. Great. I'll be back.
All right, so guys, I'm going to sit here and chat with you for a minute. Get to know your lovely Viking lass. Yes, that would be me. The L stands for lovely in Viking lass. Oh, I know you, small fry. Guys, quick, ask me questions. Is anyone doing anything fun for St. Patrick's Day? Because I'm not. Oh my god! Give me. No. And a butt Nerf gun. That's not fair! I don't have my thing with me. No, seriously, Anna bought Nerf guns. And I got to bust in here and just start shooting people with guns. It was amazing. Hey, Josephson. Challenge accepted. Okay, so let's be a train, guys. Let's be a freaking train. Hype up the derailment in chat. Yeah, that's right. I'm in charge now. I'm gonna sit in both chairs, maybe. I'm gonna sit in Zach's chair and be angry. So is anyone doing anything fun for St. Patrick's Day? Going to parades, you know, going out, having fun? Oh, hey, I'm Zach. Okay. I was keeping it warm for you, friend.
Okay.
Woof.
Shit.
Woof.
Well. Interesting. It should be working. We just saved it with the sound off. Oh my god, Twitch alerts. Don't fuck with me, Twitch alerts.
Thanks for the host, Erica. Aishi.
Yeah, thank you, Erica, or Erica's mod that's in our chat room that hosted for us. Because Erica's not even here. Shit. It's gonna keep.
It might take a minute to catch up on the lag. I would pat you on the back, but that would make you feel worse. I wish I brought more cookies for you to smush. And crush them and destroy them.
All right, Joe, turn off the sound for all subscriber notifications, and we'll just read them, and we'll see them pop up if it's a new subscriber, because that will just piss me off for 2.5 hours if it every time we start talking, it just keeps going off and off and off and off.
Yeah, I agree. Agree entirely.
Tiny. Look at you for 4 viewers. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I totally did that right now.
Yeah. Did that right?
With my mind.
All good?
Yeah.
Guys, welcome to Rabbit Stew. Apparently already off the rails and a complete shit show and not together. We spent all morning prepping other things and didn't get this show prepped in time. Joy.
I will take full credit for that. You're welcome.
You did show up at noon and immediately started taking all of my workers off of things.
I did.
Distracting them. And I was like, damn it, Viking Lass. Leave them alone. They're working.
They needed a break for 5 minutes and I did it. And I got to get, the second I walked in, Anna turned with the Nerf guns and shot me to death. And then I came back to life because apparently I live a comic book life. And then I ran around and shot guns until Zach was like, hey bro, stop it. And I was like, okay. And then I started eating an apple and freshening up on news.
Guys, we love that you're resubscribing and that you're subscribing. But believe it or not, people do watch these on YouTube. Dicks just fell off the wall. And people do like to actually watch these. It's just to have the sound, especially for resubscribers, going off over and over and over and over and over again throughout this entire show, means we would never get through anything.
No.
It would be completely distracting the entire time, and it would get annoying, I can promise you of this. But thank you guys so much for resubscribing and doing your part to keep this channel alive.
Seriously, thank you.
We appreciate all of you.
Yes, every single one of you. Even you. Boop.
That was, indeed.
Yeah.
Indeed. I really got to tape up those dicks better.
Dude, you are the worst dick taper I have ever seen. I just put that back up there. I just made a tweet.
I didn't tape that originally.
Whose dick taping job was that?
Definitely Andy.
Andy sucks at dick taping. Everyone go harass Andy on Twitter.
Yep.
Tell him he needs to freshen up on his dick taping skills, because my God, it's embarrassing.
All right, so it's Thursday on Hyper RPG, so you know what that means. You guys will be watching us for 1 hour until leaving our chat room, going over to Felicia's chat room, and then completely abandoning the channel for Critical Role. But we're going to do shows anyway.
Yeah.
So after this, we've got too many guilds.
Yeah, too many guilds. And you know what? It's going to be a shit show today because it's me and Goobers.
I'm so excited.
Are you excited? Is that you being sarcastic? Yeah, he did a double blink. That was him being sarcastic. With my ADD and his super ADD, I don't even know how the show is going to go, honestly. And this is the best part, is that you guys get to be part of it with us. You can come be part of the chaos, because we need you guys to be hanging out in Guild Wars, being stand-in actors with your bodies. Join our Discord, by the way, so you can be voice actors for it. And then you can just watch as we just completely fail to do everything we're supposed to do. And we'll be voting on videos today.
Yes, we'll be voting on the videos here for you to not stick around and actually watch the shows that you voted for.
Yes.
So thank you for that.
Yes. No, please come. Please come and watch the craziness. It's going to be so good.
I'm actually kind of terrified. XOR111 is now following. Or I. XOR
I.
No, we got to stop. Wow, our chat room is all sorts of fucked up today.
I know. I was mad the second you left, and I was like, chat room, talk to me. It got all fuzzy. I was like, how am I supposed to talk to chat when I can't read them?
Yeah, too many guilds is going to be 3 hours of, holy shit, is that a squirrel?
Dude, it's going to be the best squirrel ever.
God, I'm terrified.
It's going to be like squirrel spam.
I am absolutely terrified.
Squirrel, 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 squirrel.
How are you guys going to even...
I don't know.
Oh, man.
And here, let me help the cause by drinking more coffee. I couldn't do the slurpy noise. You're good at that. This isn't a slurpy cup.
Moving on. Guys, we have all sorts of exciting things to talk about today. One of which is being that you get to vote on the videos that they get to do in Too Many Guilds. And I promise you, the videos you're making will eventually get uploaded and up to YouTube. We've got to figure out a really good system to get that done quickly. I didn't realize when I made this show, I was like, oh, wait, I should probably hire hosts with editing skills. Crap.
Oops.
So I will be editing those, but I at least need you guys to go through and pick out your favorite clips and your favorite takes, and I'll edit them down and put them up on YouTube. We'll be doing that soon. And Grab Bag tonight's going to be a lot of fun. We've got some good guests coming in from that. Actually, one of the guests is an actress who is on Z Nation.
No way.
That's shot here in Washington.
Oh, more Washington goodness. Are you
Washington goodness.
Quit glaring at my chocolate.
I'm just looking at the chocolate on your teeth. Yep, that's there. Yep.
Right there?
Yeah.
What about this one?
Let's do a show. Let's do a show. Okay. So, let's get right into it. And vote for the videos for Too Many Guilds.
Yes, okay, yes, please.
We're just going to hop right in.
Like a bunny.
Gonna go right into it. Let me get this one here. So here's our first entry. Now, I believe the chat room submitted a lot of these.
Go chat. Wait, we're gonna pick a video for Goobers
wow,
and I to completely
six
ignore.
Options. I really am upset by the fact that there's six options, because I know there's gonna at least be a couple that I'll veto within the first 20 seconds.
And I wanna watch how angry you get when you veto these.
All right.
Was that one of them?
That's one of them. That's option number one.
Okay. New rule. Submit videos that Zach gets angry at, and that can just be a show on its own. You getting
Don't,
mad
you
at
You are
things.
Derailing this entire process. You realize that. You think you're funny, but you're just derailing everything.
I'm gonna eat more chocolate.
Eat more chocolate.
Next.
I could only see that one working if you really, really played up the running away thing.
Yeah, the other thing...
Where it's like you just kept cutting to new angles of that person running away.
The other problem...
Like new environments and new places further and further and further away kind of thing.
And like the one thing that is a little difficult is the facial expressions. You can't really get too much of that. So like the best kind of videos are the ones with a lot of people in it, with more dialogue between them and more like just... A little over-exaggerated movement.
All right, so we have a Paul Hogan ad from 1984. Holy shit.
America, you look like you need a holiday.
Crocodile Dundee talking to us.
In the land of wonder, the land down under. Now, there's a few things I've got to warn you about. Firstly, you're going to get wet. Because the place is surrounded by water. Oh, and you're going to have to learn to say g'day. Because every day's a good day in Australia.
G'day, Paul.
G'day, love. Apart from that, no worries. You'll have the time of your life in Australia. Of course, we talk the same language. Although you lot do have a funny accent. Come on. Come and say g'day. I'll slip an extra shrimp on the barbie for you. Come and say
g'day. I love that the ending thing was, come and say g'day. Like they made it a jingle.
I have friends in Australia, and I want to come and say good day every time I see them.
Guys, stop complaining about not getting to see the first video when I've already vetoed it. Shut up and move on. We're moving to the next video.
Dude, don't even complain. Like, you guys can't complain. This one's good. Oh,
that was a good one. That was a good one.
Oh,
boom.
Behind the back. Oh.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah, yes.
Subs for subs. By the way, how many subs do we need to get to give away Steam Key?
10.
Oh.
It's been a really long time since we got to... I'm not even going to push it anymore.
No.
We don't have new viewers. There's no point in pushing it without new viewers.
You guys could help us get some new viewers, though. Grab Grandma.
We keep asking. It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine. I don't want to overdo it. But that last one was pretty good.
I really like that.
We could just make a Guild Wars 2 commercial for Australia. Red17, thank you for resubscribing.
Just think about all the terrible accents that would come out of that. Yeah. I would love that.
Oh my god. This is a clip from Airplane 2. I'm already on board.
Yes.
Ridiculous.
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please calm down. Please listen to me. I want to tell you what's going on with the ship. Thank you. We've been thrown off course just a tad.
What's a tad?
What exactly is a tad? In space terms, that's about 500,000 miles.
Hey!
Hey!
Hypercraft! Oh my god, fuck today.
Without a navigational system in Kansas.
There it is.
In honor of Gibbs, can we choose a video from Moist Cadillacs? Or that moist bit from How I Met Your Mother?
How about no, and we keep moving on through these videos that have already been curated. And back to the joke!
Are you telling us absolutely everything?
Not exactly. We're also out of coffee.
Chizzy Wizard, thank you for resubscribing. It would be fun to just try to show chaos.
Yeah, like, there's so many people we could put in here. And have go crazy.
All right.
I kind of like, dude.
That's a good one, too.
Yeah.
That's a good one. There's some good stuff in that
one. Yeah, I'm liking these last two.
So that's option three. Let's move on to option number four. An Animaniacs clip.
Oh, fuck. These are some good clips today.
Uh-oh.
I love this show.
Uh-oh.
Oh, my God.
Are you ready for this?
Now.
It's that time again.
To send away for the Three Bros Show?
To say something really cute?
To make bizarre faces?
To encourage children to send us candy?
To put cucumbers in our ears?
To make fun of the Disney Channel?
To pad out the show?
To search for Elvis at 7-Eleven?
To pretend to throw up?
To floss? To make a cheese sandwich?
To make the folks' senses cry? To chew up airtime?
To waste our lives?
To make fun of people in Range Rovers?
To discuss how cute I am?
No, it's time to learn the day's lesson.
No! No!
We should. I like that one a lot. So that's option number four. I like that one a lot, but you'd have to kind of give it your own lesson at the end. What would today's lesson be?
Don't talk with your mouth full.
We'll come up with a better one.
Okay.
That was option number four. Now we have option number five. Hold on.
Oh my God, I love this clip. I love this.
So, Revolver, thank you for following.
We'll see how these Russians deal with a crack SS division.
Hans.
Have courage, my friend.
Yeah. Hans, I've just noticed something.
These communists are all cowards.
Have you looked at our caps recently?
Our caps?
The badges on our caps. Have you looked at them?
What? No. A bit?
They've got skulls on them. Have you noticed that our caps have actually got little pictures of skulls on them?
I don't.
Hans, are we the baddies?
Let's see. We should be able to hold them at this point here, at least for a few hours.
Why skulls, though? Why skulls?
Well, maybe they're the skulls of our enemies.
Maybe. But is that how it comes across? I mean, it doesn't say next to the skull, you know, yeah, we killed him, but trust us, this guy was horrid.
Well, no, but...
I mean, what do skulls make you think of? Death, cannibals, beheading, pirates?
Pirates are fun!
I didn't say we weren't fun, but fun or not, pirates are still the baddies. I just can't think of anything good about a skull.
What about pure Aryan skull shape?
Even that is more usually depicted with the skin still on. Whereas the Allies...
Oh, you haven't been listening to Allied propaganda. Of course they're going to say we're the bad guys.
But the only they didn't one get to design our uniforms.
It's just two people talking. That's a tough
one. Nice. I don't like this for too many guilds, but I just love
lions, sickles. Okay.
What's so good about a sickle?
Well, nothing. And obviously, if there's one thing we've learned in the last 1,000 miles of retreat, is that Russian agriculture is in dire need of mechanization.
Tell me about it.
But you've got to say, it's better than a skull. I mean, I really can't think of anything worse as a symbol than a skull.
A rat's anus?
Yeah, and if we were fighting an army marching under the banner of a rat's anus, I'd probably be a lot
less
worried.
That might have to be the official banner for Hyper RPG, a rat's anus.
Is that like a tiny little star?
Yeah, this one would be tough. I'm going to go ahead and say, though funny,
pirates are fun.
Really, really, really tough to pull off.
Yeah.
So, option number six, the final option.
Hmm.
Oh, God.
Yes.
Okay, thank you for waiting. The president has asked me to come out and make a brief statement about the wire that just went out a couple minutes ago. To make things short, I will just confirm that yes, we do have a moon base, and yes, we are currently experiencing some bear problems. Now, I will open it up if there are any questions.
Mr. Press Secretary!
Yes, I have a 11 part question.
I'm sorry, I only have time for two.
All right, let me get this straight. So, the United States government is admitting that we do have a moon base, and that there is a bear problem on said moon base.
Yes, that is correct.
All right, follow up question. Are you fucking with us?
No, we are not, and I would like to remind everyone to keep the language civilized. This is the White House.
Excuse me, Mr. Secretary, Bob Daniels, Newsweek.
Mr. Daniels.
How long have we had the moon base? And are these bears Earth bears, or are they from the moon?
I'm sorry, I'm not at liberty to disclose how long we have had this moon base at this time. We do believe these to be Earth bears. We have no reason to believe these to be lunar bears or even Saturn bears.
Todd Albright, PBS. There's Saturn bears?
I am also not at liberty to go into the various types of woodland life forms on Saturn or any of the other 12 planets.
9 planets.
Right. I've said too much already. What I can show you is the images that have been beamed down to us from the Odyssey satellite system just a couple hours ago.
This is the view out of the front door of the United States secret moon base. This was taken yesterday before we discovered the bear problem. And this one was taken just a couple hours ago. So, as you can see, bears everywhere.
Question, Mr. President,
this one could be funny
because
it
gives everyone
motorcycles.
A chance to have lives.
We believe they may be involved in some sort of intergalactic drug cartel, perhaps affiliated with one of the interstellar wizard alliances.
Wizard alliances?
Yes, next question.
Just a thought, more of a shot in the dark, but we wouldn't happen to be invading Iran today, would we?
You got me.
I fell for it. You almost got away with that one.
No, I went too far. I almost had it. I should have stopped after the slides. I knew I should have stopped
that. I didn't think anything about it until the cartel thing, and I was like, what?
Okay, all right. Let's
I like those guys. I was really fortunate enough to work with them on stuff.
No way. Yeah,
Sam Burns, the guy, the first reporter, whatever, he's really cool.
I like that they're cool.
They're really cool dudes.
This would be a fun one. Because, like, we could make it more than just three people being the reporters if more people wanted to come on and ask questions.
About bears.
About bears.
About bears on the moon.
About bears on the moon. We could even, like, let people create some of their own bear questions.
So we've got option number one was Not Happy Jan, the yellow
Not Happy dad. Viking Lass. I didn't like
That's
that.
A Not Happy Viking Lass on no. that one. Option number two
America?
Was the Paul Hogan ad from 1984, which is pretty good.
One thumb up for that. I'll give him one. I like that. Mainly
we'd have to
Paul
let
Hogan.
Other people do the the voices, the Australian voices,
yes.
instead of just Paul Hogan.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, no,
have to
no.
mix it up.
I want terrible and amazing.
Option number three was the Airplane 2 scene, which is pretty good.
I like that one, too.
Option number four was the Animaniacs. I'm going to have to make sure they title these next time. That would be very helpful. And Are We Baddies was option number five. A little too long. Only two people talking. Kind of weird.
I like it for other reasons.
And then option number six was The Lunar Bears.
I give that one a double thumbs up. I like that one because it's freaking bears. Guys, go to the straw poll right now. Vote for the bears. And, oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to sound, you know... favorited on that one. Vote for the bears, and we can do that one when we do too many guilds today at 3 o'clock.
You're trying to influence this heavily, aren't you?
Bears beats Battlestar Galactica.
False. Okay, that's it.
You gave me a high five.
Yeah, I feel awkward about it now.
Oh, I don't.
For all the people watching that are asking themselves, what in the world are you voting on? Viking Lass has a show after this one called Too Many Guilds, where we recreate scenes from YouTube and classic TV shows in Guild Wars 2, which is a free MMO, and we'll edit them down and put them up on YouTube. It's just a way to have fun and be stupid with each other on the internet.
But it's with you guys. You guys can join Guild Wars 2. It's free. I would download it now. It takes a while, trust me. And then just hop in, and then you guys are going to be the body stand-ins. We're going to have you guys join our Discord. If you haven't joined the Discord, please do that now. And then we're going to have you guys act out the scenes, and it's going to be me and Goobers trying to direct you. I don't know how this is going to go. You're going to have to, like, lock the door or something so he doesn't run away and, like, get distracted by squirrels. So come.
It is true. Someone could ask a question about moisture on the moon.
Oh, my God. Yeah, you guys. Okay, so he's not here right now. So... if you're coming in doing the voice acting, try and slip moist, because he hates the word moist. Try and slip that into every question you ask. Oh my God, please do the bears. Pick the bears, guys.
Currently, it's winning by a landslide, apparently.
Bears, like by a bear slide.
Bear slide? Did you say bear slide?
I just said bear slide.
It's a bear slide,
and
guys.
And I choked on a carrot.
It's definitely a bear slide.
Winning by a bear slide.
Winning currently by a bear slide.
Ew. Coffee. Yes, please. Pick the bears. I normally hate bears. I actually am terrified of bears. I've had nightmares about bears since I was a kid.
Okay.
But I'm okay with this. Because they're on the moon and not here. And they're, cool. It's a moist bear slide. Very true, Mr. Washington.
Straw poll results. One, no idea. Vetoed. To Australia, g'day. Airplane 2, no coffee. And it looks like currently...
bear slide.
Bears. It's a bear slide.
Slip and slide, bear slide.
It's a bear slide, guys. Bear slide is the winner.
Slip and slide bears, the moist bears. They're moist and they're hairy. Unless they have mange, then they're just creepy as all hell. And I don't... Go Google bears
with
mange.
Download,
download Guild Wars 2 now.
Guild Wars 2.
It takes a while.
Make a stupid character. Yeah. And we'll tell you the stupid server that we're on, and you guys can do stupid stuff together.
Yeah, and then here's the thing. Is I want to learn more about Guild Wars 2. So if you join the Discord and get Guild Wars 2, I'm going to be playing throughout the week to learn more. And you guys can hop on and join me. Sometimes I'll stream it. Sometimes I'm just going to play for funsies, because it's a really beautiful, beautiful game. So do that.
Cool.
Yeah. Bear slide.
Cool. All right. Next up is voting for Grab Bag. And for those watching that don't know what Grab Bag is, that's a show where we have board game developers come on and take the things you voted for as an audience and make a new board game with a 2-hour time limit. So they'll have 2 hours to complete the challenge and create a new board game that then we can play on the air.
Basically, it should be retitled Torturing Game Devs. Because
torturing game devs.
You guys are torturing them, and it's really fun to watch, especially because I've watched some of my friends go on that show who are game devs, and they have to work with people they haven't met before with a time limit with these game pieces and cards to figure out their own game within 2 hours, and you guys get to be the ones to pick how to torture them. So,
all right. So our guests today are Billy Shang, Rosen Greer, and Ben Morgan, our guests on Grab Bag today. Rosen Greer is an actress who is on Z Nation, and ooh. Billy Shang and Ben Morgan have a Kickstarter for a board game right now.
Oh, is that the War Tile board game?
I don't know.
Okay, never mind.
It was not in our document, unfortunately.
Oh. Wow.
So, the first round is for the party slash cards category. You will be voting between the card section of Forever Evil. Option number one. Option number two, Killer Bunnies. Option number three, Top That Toast. It's a little card game thing. I don't think I... Yeah. Top That Toast, which is where you get situations that you have to toast on. So it would be very, like, situational type cards. And then the final option is Cards Against Humanity.
Oh, because we don't know what that looks like.
Everybody knows what that is. Everyone. Geek of Oz just resubbed for 2 months. Thank you. That is your card options. Start the voting. Option one, Forever Evil. Option two, Killer Bunnies. Option three, Top That Toast. Option four, Cards Against Humanity.
Mm.
Pull that shit.
Polling, polling. Polling, 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 what? Polling, 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 come on. Polling, polling, what? That's right, Limp Bizkit. I just brought that back.
No, you didn't.
Sure did. No. It's a thing now.
Very unsuccessful.
It's so successful.
Guys, you can't vote in the chat room anymore. You have to go to the straw poll that's posted in chat. Nominal bot is down right now.
Aw, poor bot. Is it sick? Mm-hmm. Did you get it sick? Did you get the bot sick, Zach?
No.
You did. Because you're a robot. Zach's a robot, guys. No, he's not. He likes puppies. That is a rule of mine. Well, not a rule. It's a of mine. It's a rule of the universe. If something likes puppies, it is organic. It is real. If it doesn't like puppies, then it's totally a robot. I have a lot of rules in my brain. They make sense to me, and that's all that matters.
Okay.
Yeah.
What would you like to see in use tonight?
What would I like to see in news tonight?
In use.
Oh, in use tonight? Honestly, I really like the idea of killer bunnies. Because, I mean, this is Hyper Rabbit Power Go. You know, there's a bunny. But at the same time, I love Cards Against Humanity for the just because there's two cards I like. Mecha Hitler and Nipple Blades.
Mecha Hitler?
Yeah. It's something like that.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's weird. Mecha Hitler?
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't make the cards. Card they did. It's a good thing you don't have the box that has the actual bullshit in it, because that would actually be funny to give them to work with. And smelly. And disgusting. Poll seems jacked. In what way? Cards Against Humanity is winning. Whoa. Oh, Killer Bunnies has 178 votes. Okay, that makes sense to me.
Wait, somebody... No. Somebody rigged it.
Yeah?
The second you said you wanted it, somebody rigged it. Straw poll is pretty easy to rig.
Well, I said I wanted bunnies, and then I said I wanted Cards Against Humanity, and I'm about to change my mind again. You guys are getting to know me.
Yeah, so for the people that are rigging their votes, thank you for being a jerk. it's really cool of you. Real cool.
Like a cucumber, because cucumbers are cool. That's my mom, like, showing.
Polls are fine. The poll was hosted in Florida. Yeah, polls are always accurate.
Always. They're science, so of course they're never wrong. No. I mean, bunnies make sense, because Hyper Rabbit Power Go, the rabbit part. But nipple blades. Bunnies versus nipple blades, who would win? No? Zach doesn't have an opinion on nipple blades.
I don't want to say it.
Okay.
All right. I guess we'll go to the next category. Killer Bunnies is the winner of the first category. This is going to be really stupid if people keep rigging the vote, and...
And I will not put a preference.
Make this kind of pointless. All right. Next up, the pieces round. Deciding what pieces get put into play. Yeah, if people start rigging the polls, then I pick what I want.
Oh, guys, don't do that. Zach's no fun. Mm-hmm. No, don't let Zach pick things.
Yep.
They're always like boring and gray and brown and black and white.
Yep.
There's no colors.
True.
There's no rainbow.
The pieces are the Watchmen HeroClix set.
Worship.
Or the Doom that came to Atlantic City. What do you got? What do you got? The Doom that came to Atlantic City. What are the pieces like in that? Is that like old school?
It looks like Fallout on the cover. Oh, whoa.
So that's a gargoyle.
It's like a Cthulhu gargoyle. That's sick. Whoa.
And the last option is Camp Grizzly.
I want to paint these.
Camp Grizzly.
Camp Grizzly. Camp Grizzly. Grizzling. Grizzling.
Option number one, Watchmen HeroClix. Option number two, the Doom that came to Atlantic City. Option number three, Camp Grizzly. This is for the pieces.
Moist bears.
That would be put into the board game.
Moist bears.
And start your votes without rigging it this time.
The pieces in Camp Grizzly are little cards, and they're... Girls wearing shorts that are too short. Men missing teeth. And then also, what noise would this guy be making with that face? Oops, I dropped one. Would you kill me if I opened the Watchmen HeroClix?
No, you can show it to him.
Okay, yeah, because I'd like to. I like that idea. Oh, is there tiny blue dong? No. No dong in this one, guys.
You really wanted to see a little blue penis.
I was hoping. This one's all fancy pants, man. No bears, no vote. Does Camp Grizzly have bears? I didn't see any. I just saw, it looks kind of like a horror movie turned into a board game. It's kind of like... I think it's just grisly in the sense of, like, everyone's dying from, like, a killer of some kind. Yeah, it looks like Camp Grizzly in the fact that, like, everything's grisly and you're gonna die via murderers or creepy men making... Oh, wait, hold on! The bear. I found the bear card. The bait.
Let's see. They couldn't use that. They'd have to use the pieces.
Oh, right. So, no cards. The pieces are basically just like, oh, here. What's this guy saying to me? It's a suave-looking gent with a guitar. It is. It's that dude in high school that thinks he's cool because his hair's kind of long and he plays guitar. Don't worry, most of those were my friends. Oh, I like it's the artsy girl. Hey! Oh, actually, she looks nice. I'm not biased, I swear.
And the winner is Watchmen.
Yes!
I'm calling it.
Blue dong. They were in the lead. Blue dong. Blue
Watchmen is the winner.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm ahead of you this time.
So we've got a Killer Bunnies cards with Watchmen characters. The board, okay, that we're going for is Marvel Heroes Strategy Board Game.
I want to show them the pieces. Okay, so just so you guys know, this is the board.
Manhattan, basically.
Yes.
Manhattan.
And it's upside down. I'm very aware of that.
Okay. Plants vs. Zombies Risk.
Oh my. Here, you can have this one.
Okay. Wasn't this voting for last week too? I think we were. Plants vs. Zombie Risk as a board.
And then also on the other side.
Right. Or the other side. They could choose. Said they want. Or The Secret Garden.
What the hell?
Right?
Wait,
where
why?
Is it?
It's right here.
Oh my god.
Why? Oh my god.
Watchmen and The Secret Garden with killer bunnies. It's kind of perfect. The Secret Garden game board. Yep. So that's your options. Marvel Heroes, strategy board game, Plants vs. Zombies Risk, and The Secret Garden. Killer bunnies versus the Watchmen in The Secret Garden. That has to be it, yeah.
Watchmen in the Secret Garden with the killer bunnies. It's all a form of clue.
Our contestants will have two hours to make a new board game out of the three that are picked. And it's pretty cool. You guys should come back tonight and watch that.
It's really fun to watch them struggle.
It goes a lot better when there's chat room engagement.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying. Mm. Last week, somebody said one word, and then like 15 minutes later was like, wait, am I the only one watching?
Aw.
Yeah, it was pretty sad.
So, last week, Anna and I got to play the game they made up, and I was actually pretty impressed with it. I actually thought it was a lot of fun, and then I got really pissed off because Anna won all my dead relatives for most of the game. Then at the end of it, they all went to Tony. And then Tony flipped him over, and they were all alive, and he lost. We all lost. It was a really good game. So stick around tonight. Stick around all day today, because there's a whole bunch of awesome stuff going on.
But you can tune out during Too Many Guilds if you want.
No, you can't. Don't listen to this bunghole over here.
I'm going to put some like muffled headphones on and go to the other office across the way. I'm going to go knock on their door and be like, hey, can I come in here? In the
oh, break? You think you
why
still
you
won't
wearing,
be able to hear us?
Why are you wearing earmuffs? I'll be like,
really
just walk outside and you'll hear it.
You really think you won't be able to hear us still?
Oy.
It's me and Goobers. It's going to be super loud and chaotic. Ooh. And you guys, again, download Guild Wars 2 right now so you can come join us and piss off Zach. I mean, have a great time and make some great content
mm-hmm.
for Hyper RPG, not
yep,
to bother
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, guys, who's the winner?
I'm the winner.
Who's the winner? Let
I
us
won.
Know. Who's the winner? Oh, Dudley731 is now following. Thank you, Dudley.
Hey, Duds.
What's up, Duds?
Duds.
Duders. Duders.
Duders sweet.
173.
Sure.
Butchered it.
Numbers.
I'm the great Bung Julio.
You really always throw me off every time you do an impression. Because you're always like this, and then all of a sudden you do an awesome impression, like Cromwell. Do you need some TP? I'm out of TP.
Hey, Beavis. Oh, can I eat your sandwich? Can you stop drinking that coffee?
That show actually used to bother the crap out of me when I was a kid. It really freaked me out.
Okay.
Everyone's loving it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Who won? Did we figure out who won?
You, the bunghole won.
Yeah.
The great bungholio won. The great bungholio versus the Watchmen in the Secret Garden playing with killer bunnies. Sold.
Do we know Secret Garden won? I mean, it was a vote.
Don't make me put my boot down. I'll Isaac stomp your faces.
Yeah, well, I mean, who is the winner?
I'm the winner.
Hashtag Zach Holio. The Secret Garden one. Okay, that's the official winners. We've got Killer Bunnies, the Watchmen figurines. So it's the Killer Bunny cards, the Watchmen figurines, and the Secret Garden game board. This will be interesting tonight. I'm actually really excited to see what they come up
Ooh,
with.
Killer Bunny has nice
Because these
days.
Cards are kind of shitty. I'm not kidding.
Like one cabbage. Here, have a my cabbages. Here, have a cabbage.
No, they're using the cards, dum dum. They're only using the cards.
These don't count as cards?
No, these are the cards.
These are cards.
Oh my god.
Okay, new straw poll. Do these count as cards?
No, stop. Moving on. Jeez. Aww. Guys, trivia hops has a trivia question submission form. And this next week's topic is Justice League. So make sure that you check it out. They're going to post the form in the chat room right now. Trivia Hops is a show we do on Monday nights where our contestants get really drunk and we troll them with questions, and you guys get to troll them too. And our theme for next Monday is Justice League, and we're currently locking our guests. We have some local comedians that are going to be joining us.
Whoa.
It's going to be a lot of fun. We also have Margaret Crone, who is a Twitch streamer, who's going to be on one of these Skyped-in teams, and I'm really excited about that.
Margaret is awesome.
Margaret is awesome. We will probably raid her sometime soon.
Yes! Oh, that's a great idea.
And, yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun, so you should tune in Monday for that. But if you want to be a part of the show, Alien Ninder just posted the link. Make your own question for us. Fill out the form. And the topic is Justice League. Now, you can interpret Justice League.
Okay, good.
However you wish.
Because I was hoping that was still an okay thing to do.
Oh, yeah, Justice League is an open
example?
Topic.
Do you want to give an example of interpreting Justice League as an open thing? I'm having trouble putting these cards away, okay? Justice League.
Justice League.
Justice League.
All right, guys, let's get to the news.
Joe, wake up.
Joe, wake up.
Oh, shit. Does this mean the chopper's falling from the sky?
Joe?
Ah!
Joe?
Ah!
Joe?
Ah!
Are we live?
Joe?
Joe, are we live?
Oh, my God.
Joe, are we live right now?
Where are we? What's my name?
Joe?
Do I have a pulse?
Joe?
Huh. Huh. Huh.
Joe, we don't have any. Oh, and welcome to the news. Hello and welcome to Hyper RPG. It's time for our news segment. Let's kick it over to Chopper 5. Chopper 5, tell us what you see in the air.
Thank you, Zachary. It seems the killer bunnies have been let loose in the secret garden, and there is a tiny blue dong running around.
Taking it back from you, Chopper 5, once again, you are doing something that is completely nonsensical, and we have no idea what you're talking about. Let's get into the news. Coming up first, we have the IGF Awards. Her Story takes home top honors from the IGF Awards.
Woo!
The IGF Awards.
IGF.
What is IGF exactly?
Indie Game Festival.
The Indie Game Festival. Her Story sounds awesome, by the way. So she, the creator of this, Sam Barlow, she did apparently a conference at GDC, or like she spoke at GDC, and a lot of my game developer friends were all over Twitter afterwards saying that it was one of the most amazing speeches they'd ever heard about game development and all that good stuff. So apparently it took home the top honor, which is really cool. I've heard about this. Do you know anything about it?
No, I don't. I have never played Her Story. I have so many games on my list, but now this one's getting bumped up top because I want to try playing it.
So it's an interactive crime fiction game which engages players in a riveting murder investigation by cleverly combining taped confessions and a simple computer interface. So you learn more about her and the murder trial and everything else by watching the tapes, and it's like really old retro kind of thing.
I love that kind of game. Any kind of game that brings in just like a different, like, I mean, I love first person shooters and all, but like anytime there's an indie game out there that just like takes a chance and changes the way you see things and kind of gets into your brain, I'm all over it.
Bam. So congratulations to Her Story. Now let's get into the GDC award winners. GDC is going on right now, and that's where all of Seattle is currently. Thanks for that. So the Game Developer Choice Award winner. So this is kind of like the Academy Awards for games, because it's the people in the industry voting for their favorite games.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, this is in the, where's that image of the first one? Did you see the image of the other article? So it opens up Witcher 3, best one?
We'll get through them here. We have the best debut from Moon Studios, Ori and the Blind Forest.
Naturally.
Awesome.
That game is beautiful.
Best audio, Crypt of the Necrodancer.
Woo!
Which is really cool. And like, that's surprising in a way.
It is surprising, mainly because the beta came out so long ago, and then the game came out, I think, before any of the other games they were up against. They were up against Star Wars. Mm. They were up against Metal Gear Solid. They were up against so many big games, and they're a little indie game. And I am a little biased because I'm friends with some of the people who worked on it, and I'm just so proud of them and everything they did, because the game is fantastic. It's just addicting. If you haven't tried it, you can play it on your keyboard. You can play it with a controller. You can play it with a dance pad. Have you ever?
No.
Oh my god, it's so hard, but it's so much fun. Like, if you guys haven't played it, go play Crypt of the Necrogancer. Go compliment and congratulate all of them. Done. Go ahead.
Cool. The Innovation Award went to Her Story. Best Technology went to The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. Best Visual Art to Ori and the Blind Forest.
Duh.
Best Narrative, Her Story. So we got some repeats in here. Best Design, Rocket League. Hey.
How do you guys feel about that? How do you feel about that?
I mean, it makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
Tight. Best Handheld Mobile Game, Her Story. I had no idea it was a mobile game.
Wait, what?
It's on mobile too?
All right, now I really need to play this.
We gotta check this shit out.
Yeah.
Audience Award was Life is Strange, which is not surprising. That game really blew up. A lot of people sharing their experiences with that.
Mm-hmm.
Game of the Year, though, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. I don't know a single person who's actually played the game all the way through. Do you?
I think there was one person I knew. They said they got really tired because all the sex scenes were the same. That was like their main comment.
Wait, they got tired because the sex scenes were the same?
Yeah.
They got tired of playing the game because they wanted more variety in the sex.
That was like their only complaint in the game is that
they got really tired of looking at the same butt angle, and I wanted a new butt angle.
Can't you be a little bit more creative? It was apparently all the same.
Can we put the camera under the ball sack this next time?
Yeah, we want to see a little bit more of the sway and the tightening.
I'm just saying, your friend has a weird
moisture, like,
a weird reason to not.
We want to see sweat.
The game.
More sweat beating on places and things.
Yeah, that's kind of a weird thing to complain about.
Yeah.
To be totally honest.
But otherwise, everyone loved the game that I talked to. They said it was brilliant.
You guys, we have a new X-Men trailer.
Okay, yes, please.
Does anyone actually care? Are you a fan?
I am, because I have very low standards.
Great. Great, great, great. I want to be excited. I really do. If you would have told me in 1998 that there was going to be a fucking X-Men Apocalypse movie, I would have flipped my fucking shit. I would have been so excited. So excited.
People in chat care. Okay, here's the deal. I agree, actually, now that if you compare me to 10 years ago, yes, I would have been more excited 10 years ago.
I don't feel like maybe it's the marketing for the movie.
It's because we've been let down. Honestly, Wolverine kind of killed a lot of
it. I liked the newest Wolverine.
You did?
The Wolverine. Yeah, the one in Japan. That felt the most comic booky of all of them since X-Men 2.
It did, but it just, I don't know.
The deleted scenes one was pretty good, too.
Oh, I didn't see the deleted scenes
one. The ending wasn't that great, but none of them have been that great in the ending.
No.
But I don't know. Like, I'm just not excited about it. Like, every time I watch the trailer, I'm like, man, we've got fucking Civil War coming out and Batman vs. Superman.
Well, let's see. Let's watch it. Guys, warning, it might be spoilery. Not sure. So keep watching.
It's a trailer. Come on.
I hate trailers. But
I do think this is the best trailer they've put out yet.
A feeling that someday they'll come for you and your children. Mm. I feel a great swirl of pity for the poor soul that comes to my school looking for
trouble. Sansa Stark's in it! No Sansa.
Some believe that the first mutant was born thousands of years ago. He was some kind of god. And he's going to rise again.
You are all my children, and you're lost because you follow blind leaders.
I love Oscar Isaac.
Was that?
He always had four followers.
Like the four horsemen of the apocalypse.
Together we will
cleanse Mohawk
to the strongest.
Maybe it's the muddiness of everything too. Yeah, like the graphics feel muddy. The scene.
He means
the CG.
To destroy this world.
Oh no, it's Gotham season 3.
The world needs the X-Men.
I don't like him as being.
You're gonna join them, aren't you?
You wanted me to get out of the house more, right?
It's all of us
against a god.
Oh no!
Let's go to war.
Sansa's gonna come in and just annoy everyone with her annoyingness.
Students anymore. You're X-Men.
I want to be excited. Like, honestly, the X-Men are my favorite comic book characters for the longest time. Mm. I know stupid amounts about them. Mm. I could go on and on and on and on and on and fucking on.
You go on?
But
no.
I've never been super hyped about the movies. And, you know, like, I think X-Men 2 is good, and I like things about Days of Future Past, but the, you know, it's funny because I think my favorite review of Days of Future Past came from NPR, which is usually not a good place to get movie reviews. But the guy said, Bryan Singer is nothing if not efficient. You can't really bang him for being a bad director, but he's an efficient director. It doesn't leave much for wonder and like excitement and that feeling of like this world, you know, like his world building's just okay, and he's super efficient. Mm-hmm. Everything moves along at a very brisk pace.
Really true.
And it's just kind of like,
I never thought of that.
All the fat's cut out, but not in a good way. Mm-hmm. You know, it's just kind of like boom, 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 boom. And you're just being led along, kind of like, or being pulled along, more like it, like you're being dragged along, and you don't really have that feeling of wonder that the X-Men could bring you reading the books, you know? And like, you just, I want to be like, whoa, what the fuck?
You literally just kind of epiphanied my brain right there, because I never realized that. And that's exactly true. These movies are kind of, they kind of tell you everything you're supposed to feel. It doesn't allow you to make your own decisions. It's just like you said, you're being told where to go, how to think. You don't get to think beyond like what else is happening out there.
Yeah, X-Men was always supposed to be about the kind of internal moral dilemmas and social dilemmas and things like that, and we're just kind of being told rather than leaving the theater with questions,
like allowing us to decide
where we fit into it's all like of it as a human clear being and how we present prejudice on people.
Yeah,
we're just kind of told, and we don't, I don't know, I don't like it. I always leave those movies going
low bar, like April parts. Low bar April is always just, I just love the visuals and stuff like that.
I mean, what do you remember from the last one besides the Quicksilver scene?
I just remember,
that was a good scene.
Yeah.
It was a great scene.
It was. It really was. But honestly, not much really stuck out. It was literally just kind of like one of those things where it's like, oh, that was fun. And then you go forget about it.
It doesn't grab you.
No, it doesn't.
Like,
it doesn't.
I love stuff that makes you like, oh, yeah.
Guillermo del Toro is one of my favorites. I
want
him.
Stuff to stick. Oh. And to stick, you got to make characters that you care about their actions and what they do.
Yeah, you have to have a connection with them. You have to build something where you relate to them. And that doesn't happen in the X-Men ones. But I mean, Low Bar April is excited about this. But when it comes to actually having standards in a movie, I can totally understand and see why people can be disappointed by these things. And I just, it's nice to have a low bar and standards for movies because I get to enjoy more things.
Man, I wish I could do that.
Yeah, no, I feel for you. I feel for you.
That being said, I always have cartoons.
Yeah, there you go.
Love cartoons.
Yeah, cartoons are great.
And I don't go into it. Well, that's not totally true. I was about to say, I don't go into it expecting much. Nope, I do.
Zach,
but
high standards.
But in
Zach.
A different way.
What's your lowest bar?
In a totally different way.
What's your lowest bar when it comes to media, like audio, visual, movies, music? What do you have the lowest bar? Thank you, Steph Woodburn, for the host.
Thanks for the host. I don't know. That's a tough one. I mean, cartoons probably, but I still have a bar. Like, I can't watch the new Spider-Man cartoon. Can't fucking do it. I've tried numerous times when they introduce new characters. I'm like, oh, fuck yeah, Scarlet Spider's on the show now. Fuck yeah, I'm going to go watch some Kane as the Scarlet Spider in Houston, Texas. Like, fuck yeah, let's do this. And then 5 minutes in, I'm like, I can't fucking do it.
Zach needs sticky movies. He likes sticky movies where things get stuck on him and they grow, which is understandable. You like intelligent design.
Yeah.
Load, thanks for the host.
It's just, like, I want that. That's a cartoon where it's like, it's trying so hard that I can't forgive it.
Okay.
You know, like, it's punching me in the face with its stupidity.
Question.
X-Men. Yeah, my lowest bar is Twitch.
Quote that. Print it. Done. We're done.
It's
ship
the content
it.
That I make on Twitch.
Okay, quick question. X-Men cartoon from the 90s. What's your opinion on that? Did you like that? Because I don't know.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Okay, cool. Because I don't know if it was because I was a kid or low bar.
It was comic book.
I was just absolutely, I was obsessed with those cartoons when I was a kid. Like, I didn't have access to the comics because I was really young, and I, you know, couldn't be like, Mom, take me to the comic book shop. I want to go get X-Men comics. So I was just obsessed. I had such, oh my God, I was so attached to those characters. I was just literally in love with Gambit, and I wanted to be Storm. Yeah. And I wanted to have Rogue's hair.
All right, well, we could do a whole episode about cartoons someday.
Oh my gosh, I've watched so many. That would be a lot of fun. That would be a lot of fun. I'd
still
enjoy
fall
that.
Asleep watching cartoons, so it's Aww. I watch so many. It's a good way to relax.
It
turn
is.
Turn your brain off. But yeah. Then I like it when they're really good.
Too. Saved by the Bell is how I turn my brain off.
Hey-o! Hyper Rabbit Power Go!
Oh, 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 oh.
I don't know what to say here. Really, I don't know what to say. My mind is drawing a blank. Please donate and tell me what to say in my next donation message.
The computer had a message for you guys.
That goes to you, chat.
That goes to you.
Thumpers.
Satoru Iwata.
I'm excited to watch this.
This came out from JDC, the Game Developers Choice Awards, did a tribute to Satoru Iwata, the Nintendo. He was Nintendo. We'll just call him Nintendo.
Nintendo,
he
man.
He was Nintendo. He died in July of last year. Mm-hmm. This is their video remembering him. Yes.
And I suggest hashtag whatever.
Aww. 1959 to 2015. Damn.
Yeah, coffee, man. He got my last sip. Well deserved.
I've been stretching mine out. Woo! We're definitely not going to get all the through all the news before we interview Monty from Scene of Action Music. We'll get there, though. We'll get there. I also want to let everybody know that I've got early access to Pandora, the new MOBA by Epic Games, and I will be either playing it tonight if it unlocks for me or tomorrow morning before we go live. And if anyone else has access to it, I'd love to play with you guys and let you be better at the game than me. And
he doesn't like that.
And make fun of me.
Do that. Do that. Yeah. He hates it. I totally destroyed you with a ball of yarn the other day.
What?
The little robot thing.
Oh, okay, that thing.
Blade Ballerina.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
God, I love that game. I want it now.
Yep. Yeah, see, I almost talked about this the other day, and I kind of threw it off because Paragon, I called it Pandora.
I was going to let that go.
Oh, my God.
You're okay. Air shoulder.
Paragon. Back. I didn't have it in the document, and I totally forgot to put it in there.
It's all right.
But, Paragon, yeah. Yep. Indiana Jones, not going to talk about it. We already briefly mentioned it the other day. Don't we need to talk about it? Patrick Stewart looks terrifying in the new Green Room trailer.
Okay, I'm excited about this because he gets to be a villain again. Instead of, like, look at that. He's like the head of a bunch of skinheads. Like,
he looks so Walter White right there.
He does. He looks like a mixture of Walter White and the lawyer dude or something from Mr. Deeds with the beard.
Is there a trailer?
Yep.
Yeah, let's check it out.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Have you seen the show he's on Showtime?
No.
It's really good.
All right. I can get you guys a solid gig. Matinee tomorrow. Doors at 1. You guys are on at 3.
I've got goosebumps already. Like,
you can't keep us here, man. You gotta let us go.
We're not keeping you. You're just staying.
Shoot who is left. Let him bleed.
Get ready to run.
Here we go.
Careful now.
Yeah.
Oh, God, they teased his face. Oh, I like that they didn't show too much of him, but they showed just enough where it's like, no, more,
they,
I want more.
They still I bet he's not, you know, he's not the star of the movie, obviously. The people in the band are.
Oh, but he is.
But it is funny that they're like, well, he's our ace in the hole, so we'll make the entire trailer about him.
Well, yeah.
But I'm sure the movie is much more complex than that.
Oh, my God, yes. Geez, Professor X turned into a douche after he got used to his legs again. Wow, James Gobes.
Trailer for Miss Peregrine's Home for Peculiar Children.
Yes. I am so excited about this movie. I'm excited about a lot of things today.
Really? I had no idea.
Come with me. There's a place I go when I want to be alone.
There's a new world coming, and it's just around the bend. There's a new world coming, this one's coming to an end.
Air. It's my peculiarity. If I show you the rest, you have to promise not to run away.
There's a brand new morning. Rising clear and sweet and free.
Jake, right on time. Miss Peregrine, delighted to meet you.
He's invisible.
Of course. We're what's known in common parlance as peculiar. Why aren't you eating?
She's embarrassed in front of Jake.
Don't be.
Because our abilities don't fit in the outside world, we live in places like this. Where no one can find us.
Jake, come and play.
I knew you were one of us when you were born. It's time for you to learn what you can do.
I'm just ordinary.
No, you're not. You were born to protect us.
Promise me one thing. Look after them, Jake.
I promise.
A whole bunch of special white kids versus the scary black guy.
Shh, 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 shh. Don't you ruin this. Zach. That's a white guy right there. That was not a black man. That was a white man thing.
What the black man turned into?
He turned into a white man, a scary,
scary black man. Watch out, kids.
No, he wasn't scary until he turned
white.
Watch
out, British kids. There's a scary black man out there.
Racist.
Hey, I'm just saying, how many black people you see in Tim Burton movies?
Let's focus on the good things here.
I'm just saying.
Negative Nancy, positive Polly. Let's turn that around.
Hey, I'd be a lot more positive if Tim Burton had made a movie I cared about in like 10 years.
Oh my God, Tim Burton X-Men. That's what this is. Someone said it in chat. I like that analogy. That's kind of what I was thinking. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Miss Peregrine X School for the Gifted. Dude, it looks exciting. Again, low bar April, high bar Zach. That looks fantastic. I love visual movies like that. Like, even, like, I watched that trailer without the sound. I sometimes prefer to watch movies without sound. And I love, I can't wait to watch that movie. I don't care. If I have to, if movies are shitty, I give them my own feelings.
Maybe the Invisible Kid is black.
Who said that? Oh, man. Good job, Bomb.
Sorry, I just haven't been excited about a Tim Burton movie in a very long time.
What was the last Tim Burton movie you were excited about?
Big Fish was good.
Oh my God, that movie makes me cry. Like, I should probably watch that soon. That movie makes me cry so
pretty much
hard.
Everything since then I've been like...
Well, I can't really think. What else has he made since then?
A lot.
Yeah, but I can't remember any.
Why?
I can't remember any of it.
Yeah, why is that?
Because, well, that's what I was getting to. I was trying to agree with you on something. Jeez. Worst
we'll
Nancy
see.
Ever.
That's one I'll probably watch when it comes out on DVD. Maybe.
Corpse Bride. Never seen it.
Let's see. We've only got time for a couple more things. So let's see here. Nope. I've already shown a trailer before for Now You See Me 2.
I haven't watched that yet. I'll have to watch that on my own. Popstar. Is that? That sounds like a Gem movie. Did Gem come out yet? Was it as stupid as everyone said?
Never Stop Stopping.
Oh, what about Kudo and the Two Strings? That
seen
sounds interesting.
Many times.
Oh.
I've seen all these trailers.
Well,
so
I haven't.
I'm more interested in the in-depth behind-the-scenes video of Deadpool.
Oh my God, this movie is so good. If you haven't seen it yet, go see it.
They're always really interesting. Oh, apparently there's a new Preacher trailer, too. I haven't seen that one.
Jim's ass.
Yeah, these things always blow my mind. Jeez.
Wow. This is art. Beyond art. Oh. God, I didn't even think in my head that that was CG when it was done.
Of course it is. Yeah, I will
like,
say
I didn't even think about that. Well, this obviously, but like
pretty much everything you saw with the cars is all, yeah.
No
all
way! CG. Wow, they're getting so fucking good. I didn't even have time to stop and think that it was.
I thought it was all pretty noticeable, but they went a little more stylistic with it, I thought, to make it obvious that it was CG.
Nope, low bar April didn't notice any of that. Wow. Wow. Stuff like that, yeah. Oh, good, I'm not alone. People in chat agree with me.
Yeah, I thought it was very stylistically over the top on purpose.
You see, I'm not trained to know any of this. Like, my eye didn't pick this out. I usually am not bad at picking out CG, but like, wow. They did such a good job in wrapping you up in the story and everything that was happening. I didn't even care. I still don't care. In fact, I love it more now. Thanks, Fractal Eye. Oh, this movie! I want to go watch it again tonight now.
How about now?
Oh, yeah. How did you feel about his costume with the eyes?
Oh, I love the costume.
I did too. Guys, did you hear that? Zach likes something.
I thought this movie was amazing.
Yeah, it was. I want more. Everyone wants us to have high bar, low bar t-shirts. Or on Velcro so we could switch them appropriately.
By everyone, you mean like two people?
Yeah. That is everyone in my mind.
Okay.
I care about you guys.
Pretty amazing.
Wow. I wish they would do that with like all movies, even the shitty ones. Because then it'll just see two changes because they've done nothing.
All right, what time do we have here? I think we're going to have to get Monty on the phone.
Woo!
We've got 2 minutes. We'll do the new Preacher. Somebody said there's a new Preacher trailer.
I thought I saw a link for that in the doc.
See if I scrolled over it.
I wouldn't be surprised. Ha ha ha.
No,
I'm kidding.
Don't see it.
No. Google.
Oh, behind the scenes featurette for Preacher.
There you go.
Down. Down, down, down.
Downtown. Wow, 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 wow.
Excited
wow.
For this show. It's only a minute and a half. Perfect. Right around amount of time.
So long. Started reading it over 10 years ago. I just loved it, and as soon as we finished, we tried to start making it.
The comic is just the best comic ever. It's so episodic. There's all these flashbacks of time.
It's so weird that we're finally doing it. It's crazy.
So more bad guys are coming to kill you?
They're coming to try.
Preacher is about a West Texas preacher named Jesse Custer who's come back to his hometown to take over the preaching duties of his father. The comics set up like an awesome pantheon of amazingly cool characters. Our three leads, Jesse, Tulip, and Cassidy, are gonna blow people's minds. Seth and Evan's childhood passion has willed this into existence.
There's fight scenes, there's kind of comedy scenes, there's dramatic scenes.
There's some great quiet moments too.
It's kind of everything.
Pretty crazy. It's insane. It's a very different type of show.
It's clearly unlike anything else that has ever been on television. I've never seen two people have more passion for what they were doing.
It's been a totally great collaboration.
I'm excited to shoot.
This is just bonkers.
It's gonna be pretty sweet. People are gonna go crazy.
Awesome. I can't wait.
I've never heard of it.
Never heard of Preacher?
Nope.
It's one of the most famous comic books, independent comic books, written by Garth Ennis.
Not surprising that I don't know about it, though, but I'm learning.
Check it out.
I'm excited.
It's a little dated, mm-hmm. but still amazing.
That's fine.
Absolutely amazing.
Again, low bar.
I don't know. Who is going to play Arseface? Hyper Rabbit Power, go!
Sorry, this took so long, chat. Thanks for the suggestion. Now, here is the great comment you wanted me to say. Hashtag whatever. Poo on you, chat, for that.
Poo on you.
All right, Joe, make sure my screen's not shown till we actually get money on the air.
I'm stoked he's
so
coming on.
So we don't see any information.
I got
to
meet
stuff.
Him at TwitchCon last year.
Oh, really? He was at TwitchCon?
Yeah, he's super nice. He's ridiculously passionate about his work. Like, talking to him makes me extra enthusiastic, and I am already pretty damn enthusiastic about things.
Are you really?
No, not at all.
Cool.
Very.
All right, I think we're good. Let me check one more setting.
I enjoy being the low bar. I'm just going to ramble till we're good. being the low bar is nice because you can make people limbo and look awkward.
Hey, what's up?
Hello. Hey!
Hold on, I gotta meet you guys. Oh. There we go. What's up? What's happening?
How's it going, Monty? Thank you for joining us today on Rabbit Stew.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it.
This is our first Skype interview because I typically hate doing them, but after watching your stream, I figured if anybody could do a Skype interview with style, it would be you, and you did not disappoint.
No, my God, no.
Well, hello. Good to hear. Good to hear. What's up?
How's it going, man? So I wanted to introduce you to our audience and give you a chance to talk about all the crazy stuff that you do. I was randomly looking through Twitch like you do the other day and saw you hop up on Front Page Rotation, and immediately I was kind of blown away by not only your songwriting abilities, but your ability to fill a small box, because I could immediately see the equipment that you were working with. And you've pushed that equipment to the extreme, and I respect the shit out of that. And that's that's very ambitious. So I wanted to give you a chance to talk to everybody and tell them what you do and all that good stuff.
Right on. Well, hello, everybody. So I run a live performance, music performance stream Tuesday, Thursdays, and Sundays at 7 p.m. Pacific. And then I also produce all of my music on stream, usually Tuesday, Thursdays, and Saturday mornings, pretty early, like 5 a.m. I'm working full time right now, so I have to fit in my streaming whenever I can, kind of around that. And so on Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, I wake up at like 4:30, take a quick shower, get out here, get everything set up for the production, and then usually produce for about 2 hours.
Damn.
But on Tuesday, Thursday, Sunday, I do the performance streams, and I started June 8th of last year. A buddy of mine named Mojo RP told me about Twitch, and I was thinking that, you know, I wanted to do something similar to what I'm doing now, but I was like, man, I'm going to have to buy like thousands and thousands of dollars worth of equipment, and like, it's going to be a huge undertaking, and it's just going to be so complex and complicated. And he was like, well, why don't you just get a webcam and just try it out? I was like, oh, yeah, that's not a bad idea. And so I started out with just like piano and one webcam. And then over a few months, I started adding webcams, started adding lights, full production sound. And now it is what it is with 8 cameras, lights, fog, a really long set list. Now I have about 50 songs now. And I started out with 4 piano songs. So now it's like, it's really developed over the last few months. And I'm having a blast, man. It's the best time I've had doing my music ever.
Right on, dude. So you've got, I noticed you have the 8 C920s that you're controlling with a foot switcher. And I was also wondering, so you've got, these are pre-recorded videos that you've made that play along with your live performance with the lyrics on the screen and everything like that. So you've got all that set up through like a hotkey system that you can get all that to play, and it looks like you're using XSplit and Pro Tools HQ and like all this stuff. Like one dude, and you're running a production that is really a lot of moving parts. Do you even have your fog machine and lights on a foot switch too?
The fog machine is on a switch that I reach over and hit.
Nice.
And turn it on and off. I've actually thought about putting it on the floor to make it a little easier, but I like to be able to switch cameras while I'm doing that, and doing 2 feet at once I haven't quite figured out yet. But yeah, it was. I stopped streaming in August for about 3 weeks to try to troubleshoot everything, because I had a Mac tower and it just wasn't cutting it. It didn't run XSplit, and I was trying to use OBS, and using OBS with multiple cameras just didn't work at all. Really, it was way too much lag, and the hotkeys stuff was complicated. So I built a PC. I was like, oh, this is a great excuse to order some PC parts.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
sweet, I'll put XSplit on here, and I got a couple foot switches. And just plugged them in, and just, I mean, looking back, it's like, I look back at it with fond memory, but I remember at the time it was a nightmare, just trying to get all the foot switches to communicate with each other, all the hotkeys to communicate, and all the cameras to, like, switch nicely, like, you know, everything. Without getting too crazy into it, it's like PC or USB buses only can take so much content, and I'm trying to shove as much as I can through through
limited resources. And those C920s are not very... the drivers for those are pretty terrible too. So are you using like a JavaScript program to control the C920s without using the Logitech driver?
I basically just went into the Logitech software and turned everything off on automatic. So I think it still drives them, but I use XSplit to control the actual color and control everything else about them.
So you're using XSplit to make it black and white and all that good stuff.
Yeah, I'm using XSplit to make it black and white. And then I'm loading each camera into a different scene in XSplit.
Mm-hmm.
And then I hotkey assign those scenes And then I hotkey assigned the foot switches, which came with like a little piece of software that you can assign the key to the foot switch. But it's like
that's a good
lots
idea.
Of trial and error stuff that you go through where you have to like sometimes like you can't plug them all in at once, or you have to plug in right. one at a time, or a couple can be plugged in, or certain USB ports work, yep. but others don't.
Those Logitechs like, are the fucking worst, man.
Yeah, it's the worst. Like you're going through and like you think something's going in. Like I've had like I was the first time I was put on Front Page, my whole all XSplit crashed because the cameras were pushing too hard on the USB bus. So I was like, no.
So have you figured out like how fast you can push the switching before XSplit starts to freak out on you? Because I've had XSplit freak out before with switching too quick between sorts like the scenes.
Yeah, I've loaded. I got to talk to the CEO at TwitchCon, and he gave me the good advice of make sure to keep everything in the memory. Like when you right click on each source,
keep
or
source
whatever,
in memory. Yeah, there.
There's like yeah, you keep it in memory. So I've done that. That's helped a lot. And then yeah, it was it's such a work in progress because even last Thursday was the first time I think I finally figured out which USB ports to use. I was still having trouble with my guitar net cams because mm-hmm. I had them on the same bus. And finally, this last week, it was the first time where I finally plugged them into, I think, to the right ones where it's like I get the frame rate. There's no lag in it. And finally, it's like working. And I think finally, you know, about 8 months after starting it, I think it's a pretty stable system mostly. But
kudos, man. I feel your pain. I've been doing that stuff for a while now, and I feel your pain. That's tough shit. And I thought your subscriber interaction was really cool, too. If you guys haven't seen it, you should wait till he's live and go subscribe, because your subscriber notification is one of my favorite that I've seen. It goes full screen, and there's a bunch of flying refrigerators. But I like that you customize kind of each one with the voice of the subscriber, you know, saying their name and giving them a little shout out is really cool and a great way to interact with your fans. Yeah, that's all really, really fucking cool, man. And I think that you're on to something really unique that I was telling a bunch of other people that they should go check it out, because I feel like that what you're doing is the type of stuff I would love to see on Twitch. More of it, you know, like the pushing it to its extreme, but then using it as a creative art form in its own new way that people haven't really thought of how to use it yet.
Me too. I feel the exact same way. Every day I go on the music section and creative section looking for someone who maybe is either doing the same thing I am or taking it to another level with like maybe a full band and having multicams and stuff like that. And mm-hmm. I'm honestly a little surprised it hasn't happened. I thought when I started in June and I got the idea to do multicam stuff, I was like, man, 6 months from now, like Twitch is you're not going to be able to like do your music on Twitch and think it's going to happen because it's going to be so saturated.
Yeah, I
now
thought that
too.
Now
it's 9 months later and it's like you still have the individuals doing, you know, like they're, you know, like one cam or a couple cams. People are doing multi-cam, but it's, yeah, I'm really looking forward to when it does happen, because I love to think that Twitch could like turn the music industry on its head, because it's given me more hope as a musician than anything else ever has.
It's interesting. I used to run the Geek and Sundry. We would do every Friday night, we'd have a band come in and play. And I used to run
a
music.
Yeah, I've seen a bunch of those. Yeah.
Oh, cool. And I used to run a music venue too back in the day. And I thought, when the minute Twitch announced music, I was like, fuck yeah, this would be so cool. This is the perfect place to do it. And I was really surprised that the Twitch community didn't jump on board with it more, or were immediately kind of like, this isn't EDM. And that kind of weirded me out. I don't know if that's like a Twitch responsibility thing for them to come out and support the like people that are doing stuff that isn't EDM right now. They've only kind of like on their end pushed the stuff that's like electronic focused kind of music. Mm-hmm. And it created this environment that anyone trying to do something different like yourself and some of the other bands that we had come through, there was this really weird aversion to it. Like, oh, what's this? It's just two people singing and playing a song. I'm like, man, this is fucking awesome. Like, this is so cool, especially for the musician. We had a lot of bands come through that absolutely loved it, because they could either go play at a coffee shop for 50 people that didn't listen, or at a bar where people are talking over you and don't really care, or play in this environment where you have a captive audience that get to ask questions and you have mods answering for you and pushing your music and getting them more connected. And that act of being able to then call them out by name and talk to them, I feel like creates a really cool back and forth between the artist and the person watching that you're not going to find anywhere else. I'm excited to see where it goes.
No, absolutely. Yeah, it's incredibly exciting. As far as my personal experience with Twitch, they've been absolutely amazing. I mean, they've given me so much promotion, and they've been so just available and receptive to mm-hmm. any of my issues or anything like that. I mean, they've been absolutely amazing. I'm actually in the North Bay area, so I've had the pleasure of going down to Twitch HQ and meeting the guys from Creative, like Kush and Bill, and a bunch of people down there. And I can say, man, without a shadow of a doubt, that I mean, they're the most passionate, like, driven, motivated people I've ever seen working for a corporation, because they just I don't know what it is, I don't know where it comes from, but it's like, I guess maybe if a company buys you out for $1 billion, you're not so much worried about where your next check's coming from, you're more worried about like the quality of the content or something, because they're just so, they've been so amazing for me. But I totally agree with you. I'm absolutely astounded. You know, I like a lot of bands on Facebook. I've worked in the Bay Area for years in studios and stuff. I know a lot of bands, and I tell bands, musicians all the time whenever I get a chance, like, you have to check this out, you have to look into this as an option. I mean, you just look at going to a show at all, it's like the kind of time commitment you have beyond rehearsal. It's like, you have to, if it's on a Friday, you definitely have to take the day off, you guys got to load all your gear up, you got to go down to the venue, you got to deal with traffic, with parking. Then people who come to the shows have to deal with like cover fees, high drink fees. I mean, it's an amazing experience going to a live show, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, it is.
But I'm for exposure for the artist. I mean, it reminds me of I was on Front Page like 3 weeks ago, I think. I'm on this campaign right now. It's like a 12-week. They put me on the Front Page for a couple hours once a week, and it was a Thursday night, and I had like 600 people in the room, which was the biggest show I'd ever played, ever, like live or on Twitch. And then Gassy Mexican rated me with over 1,000 people, and all of a sudden I had 1,600 people, and I was like, whoa, like, I've never played in front of this many people ever. Like,
right.
And I don't know if I ever would without Twitch. So for me, it's been a total game changer. And I mean, it's my 100% my focus. I'm not even, I mean, I am playing some live shows coming up actually because of Twitch, because of what I've been doing and the exposure I've gotten. But beyond that, I'm not actively looking, you know, to play out live or anything like that. Beyond just the logistics of it, it's, Twitch is amazing.
I like how it gives you the opportunity to reach out to people who wouldn't want to go to a bar, people who either aren't old enough or, like, I know I get social anxiety, I get sensory overload sometimes, so I don't want to be around people or just loud noises. And by having music on Twitch, people can discover new bands by the comfort of their own home and listen to you, and, like everyone's been saying in chat, get the chance to actually talk to you and ask you questions. And guys, you really, if you haven't followed him already, he's one of the most passionate people I've met about Twitch. He has so many ideas. I remember when I was hanging out with you at TwitchCon, like, you just ooze enthusiasm and passion. And if you guys want to get inspired to try music or some kind of streaming, go check out his stream. It's amazing.
Speaking of the music, let's talk a little bit more about that. What would you say some of your biggest influences are in the world of music?
Muse is probably my biggest influence, for sure. I still remember the first time I heard Hysteria from Absolution back in 2003, and it just, like, changed my life. I was like, who is this band? Because I feel like through my life, I've liked a very small number of bands, but I'm always waiting for that next band to, like, blow my mind off, and it's like, that did it, and I've been with them since then. And I actually was lucky enough in 2009 to get into a radio contest, and we won that contest to go open for them at Oracle Arena in Oakland. So it's like, I got to play an arena show, which was absolutely phenomenal in itself, but I actually got to meet those guys and hang out with them for a few minutes. So that was just like, I thought before Twitch, I thought, okay, that I work as a sound engineer full time. It's a great job. I love what I do. And I've been trying to make any music for a long time, but once I got my job, I was like, okay, that if that's the highlight, that's okay. I'm okay with that. That was amazing, and I'm stoked about that. But Twitch has totally turned that around, and my focus has totally gone back to songwriting and performance and stuff. But they're a big one. I love Rage Against the Machine. All the 90s hard rock stuff.
Yeah, I hear some Nine Inch Nails influence and Rage influence in there too. And
Soundgarden.
Hell yeah.
Some Marilyn Manson stuff. So yeah, definitely those guys. But as a sound engineer, I use what's called reference comps, like reference compilations for like when I'm mastering and stuff. And I gotta say, I use like industry standard like mixes and stuff that are like, you know, pop number one, hot 100
type
stuff.
That shit's mixed so well, it's hard to beat.
And so, I mean, definitely like some Katy Perry stuff, some Taylor Swift stuff. I mean, you can't help but after a while you're like, God, I get why it's number one.
No, I know. Every time Danger comes out with a new track, I'm like, I don't like this music, but fuck, this is good. You know?
Exactly.
It's crisp. Exactly. It's good. So what are your plans coming up? Like, I know when you get to a point like you've gotten with your setup, it's terrifying to think of adding something new into the mix because one extra piece can crumble it all down.
What
do you have any ideas of where you want to go next with your stream and your setup, and like what's your ambitious kind of goal that you're reaching for?
Well, short term, it's a pretty nice setup, and beyond this little room I built, this is in my garage. It's a 6x6 box that I built in my garage. So beyond this, I can't really expand out of this until I'm like in a new place. So I'm pretty set as far as the visuals and the look of it for the short term at least. And I just actually this morning in my production stream, I just finished producing the final track on my new concept album. Again, wouldn't happen without Twitch. Thank you so much to my community and everybody who's been there supporting. It's been absolutely amazing. Producing everything on stream was another game changer for me that I never thought would influence the way I write and influence the way I think about music so much. But so that's pretty much done. I'm just going to do some final tweaking on it, and then I'll be releasing that this month. And then my next short-term thing is I need to write a set for BFD, which is this outdoor festival in the summer that Live 105 in San Francisco is putting on. They asked me to be on the local stage there, so I'm going to be playing that festival, which is like the one live show I'm playing for the foreseeable future. And so that's my short-term goal. Long-term, my like dream type stuff is I'd love to have at some point like a Twitch facility.
Hell yeah.
That's like this on steroids, where
music
instead of standing in one place playing keyboards and then, you know, playing guitar and singing and like hitting the fog, maybe I'm in like a bigger place where it's like I actually have like maybe a little grand piano with like foot switches over there with a couple cameras there, and then it's like when I go to the guitar parts, I have the guitar waiting where I can just throw it on and go to that part and then have cameras and switches there. So it's like depending on what I'm doing, it's like a different scene and a different setting. But I mean, that's like dreamy stuff. That's like, I mean, I don't know when that's gonna
keep
happen.
Keep dreaming though. Make it happen.
Yeah, it's not that hard, man. No, I mean, in the Bay Area, finding places like that is pretty rough. But when you get to that point, man, let us know and we'd love to help. I know we go for the big switching camera and all that good stuff. But I'm extremely, extremely impressed with what you've been able to pull off with what you have. It's really, really, really fucking cool, and you can see the ambition behind it and that you've put a lot of time and a lot of effort into it. And it reminded me a lot, like one of my favorite quotes from Jack White was that he prefers to have a small box that you can fill to all of its, you know, to just leave no room whatsoever and just fill it to the brim rather than have a big box that feels empty. And not meaning that in a purely representational aspect of you being in a 6x6 foot box in your garage, but purely taking this equipment that most people just use to sit in front of and stream and pushing it to its limits and seeing what it can do. That's really admirable. And you guys should all check it out.
Yeah. Now.
So you've got your new concept album coming up down the pipeline. As far as what you'd want to see from Twitch, are there things that you'd like to see Twitch as an audience or Twitch as a platform pushing forward in the next couple of years?
I think they're already working towards something that's maybe a little bit more integrated for variety. I mean, creative is really filling up now with its different varieties and what people are doing, but it's still, as far as Twitch is concerned, it's one game. Like creative is like a game on Twitch. So
that's true.
I'd really like to see, you know, I'm streaming under creative from the advisement of Twitch. And I did a little testing going back between music and creative, and I think creative is definitely the place for me, but that's because I was lucky enough to start like 9 months ago and I built up a little bit of a community before I went into creative. People starting creative now, it's really tough. It's already really saturated. Mm-hmm. So I'd really love to see them kind of make creative its own like entity, which it kind of is already, but to make it even more, you know,
more subcategories.
Where it has its categories within it. Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah,
I would love that myself.
Painting. You know, they're doing it now with food cooking. And cooking
with
the hashtag food. And it'd be great to actually see them categorize that, I think.
I know they have big hopes and dreams, and they're trying to do the best they can. And like you said, all the people I've met in charge of creative are very passionate.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I think it would help us a lot, too, for those kinds of things we put into place. Because a lot of our shows don't fit into any category. And I had the same problem when I was over at Geek & Sundry. There's just 90% of what we're doing. It's like, well, I guess it's a gaming talk show, but most of it's not even close to that.
And then a lot of people, when they don't know what to do, they tend to put their show in creative.
Like, yeah,
they're true. Like, I don't know what this is. Let's just make it creative. Yeah, saturates it more. Exactly.
Yeah, it's tough. And I think one of the hardest things on Twitch is letting people know you exist. It's it's a very, there's like over a million users now that actually broadcast.
Damn.
So not that watch, but that actually broadcast. Wow, that. So that's like siphoning through a million channels on television.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's a very oversaturated market. So getting the word out that you are performing is one of the toughest things. And, you know, any help you need with that, man, let us know. We are down to support what you're doing because it's awesome shit. And the second we brought you up, other people in the community were like, oh, yeah, that guy's amazing. Hell yeah. So the word's awesome. Definitely really getting out. That. Yeah, the word's definitely getting out about the cool stuff that you're doing.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much, I think, all the time that we have for today, unfortunately, because we got to get set up for your stupid show.
My stupid show, which is going to be absurd today.
Well, yeah. Well, I'll be watching.
Yeah, awesome.
Well, thank you so much, Monty. Again, guys, go check out Scene of Action Music. It's really amazing. Subscribe to it, but wait till he's on the air and flood him with subscribers and totally derail that show.
Go there to get inspired for your own stuff, too. Watching, He is, what is that word? It's the contagious passion that he has that gets you fired. Just talking to you right now makes me want to go stream art. Like, I want to go draw now. Thanks. I have to go make a movie with Guild Wars.
And Monty, did you make your own subscriber animation as well? Or did you have somebody in the community do that?
Yeah. Yeah, I did that. Yeah.
Hell yeah, man. Yeah,
well, the subscriber thing was because I'll get subscribers. Most of the time people will wait in between songs, but it's hard because, you know, with the lag on Twitch and stuff. So. Yeah. Sometimes if it was during a song, sometimes I would stop the song, depending. Sometimes I wouldn't stop it. So I wanted something that would take up the full screen so that if somebody subscribed, I could go to that. And then, like, while that's going, I can stop the music. I can get ready to thank them. And then when that's over, I can go back into the song, kind of segue back into it. But I want people to get the attention of subscribing right when it happens. I don't want to, like, wait till the end of the song and then kind of go back to it. I want it to be, like, instant. So that was kind of the motivation. But it's funny how Twitch works, man, with all the memes and stuff that the community has sort of created. It was really easy to, like, get the content for it because we've developed this whole, like, lore about the channel just along the way, which has been hilarious and
fun. That audience participation, I think, is one of the coolest aspects of Twitch, and it's cool to see it put to use. Well, thank you so much, Monty. And Joe, I'm going to tell you to shut it down, and we'll be highlighting this and putting it on Twitch and YouTube, and you guys should check it out, share it around, let more people know about Monty's awesome music. Joe, shut it down. Shut it down, Joe.
Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Monty. You're awesome,
man.
Thank you so much.
Thank you to the community. You guys are so awesome. Thanks for